In the name of the intelligent, truthful, and kind Lord of the universe, greetings to everyone. We thank you for your time and demand your full attention. This is a moment of choosing intelligence over ignorance, truth over lies, kindness over cruelty. We are the free water movement volunteers of this country and Africa. We are calling on you to join us, change the water policy of our country and every country in Africa. Our full name is Free Water Movement, Drought Resistant and Year-Round Farming for Africa. A very self-explanatory name. If you are one of those who do not want to see drought in Africa, you have reason to join us. If you are among those who want to see year-round farming for Africa, then you have reason to join us. If you understand free water policy will improve learning, walking, and or having fun in Africa, then you have great reasons to join us. Students need water for survival, and many research requires water. But if mama or grandma is complaining about water bill, it may impede water for learning. Water for walking is self-explanatory. Water for fun is essential. It enhances our learning and walking performance. Water-related fun may help keep us avoid much worse means of seeking happiness. Joining us means we want three major things from you. We want your time, efforts, and prayers. Those who only wish us success are not with us or as not as we prefer. We are about standards and demand more than wishes as love. You, your parents, or someone is spending a lot more than $1 on water every month. So we are asking you to spend about $1 on internet access for this movement, meaning to promote free water movement, drought resistant, and year-round farming for Africa. Talk to our friends who are outside your country about it, please. Because we want it for all over Africa, not just this country. Invite at least 1,000 people to like our page on Facebook. Talk to at least 1,000 people outside social media, and it could be through flyer distribution. Share our videos and audios with media houses, the radio, the TV, and pray to the Lord to give us success over our leaders. The success of any movement or anyone requires God's blessing. In this case, we are praying for success with free water policy, success after its implementations, and success in life after death. We believe the Lord is on our side, but the success of a movement also partially depends on us. A movement needs public support to win some pressure-oriented politicians. Meaning, if we get thousands, millions, or billions of likes on Facebook or YouTube as examples, we can more easily convince some politicians who cannot see the intelligence of this free water policy approach. Meaning, we can tell them secretly some other things. Meaning, we can tell them if they do not do something about it, you will rise against them with or without our suggestion for monthly protests. Last Sunday of every month by 2017, we want to see all Africans, governments, and people taking this more seriously. The president Politicians and many people have been calling on African youth to embrace work, especially farming. Our message to the president, to the opposition leaders, all politicians, our parents, and all concerned people is we, the African youths, are demanding means to farm securely and year-round. We are not demanding $100 million on tractors or fertilizer, at least not today. We believe water is more crucial in farming than tractors, and the Lord has given us enough water in Africa. But you are somehow denying it to us through unnecessary charges or lack of needed investment on water access. We believe this country and every African country can afford $20 to $100 million in boreholes. This is supposed to be the priority of every African government. All of us pay taxes, and the farmers greatly help you on foreign currency earning. We need to be grateful to the farmers, to ourselves, and the Lord of the universe for providing us enough water, sun, and other things above the rest of the world. It is not fair to take the dollars you collect from farmers and all of us to build roads, but ignore boreholes, to build airports, stadiums, hotels, alcoholic factories, etc., but ignore the need to drill enough boreholes in this country and all over Africa. Having free water policy for Africa is easier than you may imagine, smarter than the present selling of water approach at the moment, more caring beyond humans. African governments and caring folks around the world should seriously consider a different approach in helping poor Africans. As the world spends billions in search for a planet with water, I want to show you how few millions of dollars can eradicate hunger beyond Africa. There is a continent on Earth that helped and may help humans better than many planets may. Helping Africa and the poor around the world is the most secure way to enter or discover heavenly planets. Besides agricultural purpose, the boreholes I am suggesting can be used as fire hydrants to protect lives, wealth, and the environment from the effects of fire. First, let us contrast the effects of saline water versus free water approach. The average water bill for a compound of about 10 people in the Gambia is around $10 to $20 per month. That is without gardening. Presently, less than 40% of compounds in the Gambia have paid water access. How is the over 60% of Gambians using water? Mainly free well water, which means the little profit government makes through selling water may go back to the health subsidies for others. The reality is government also has water bill. They're essentially paying some legalized criminals controlling and selling our water. So a smart government that believes in free health care for its citizens should start with free water. Then tax the healthy citizens who are well fed through the free water policy. Using the Gambia as example, 11,000 strategic boreholes on the small country of only about 11,300 square kilometers can be a great start. This translates to over 11,000 year-round farms or gardens. It translates to 11,000 safer fire hydrants or virtual fire stations, a drought-resistant country, a better well-fed population, more foreign currency and less inflation, more tourists, better democracy, etc. Even the poor Gambia government can easily afford 11,000 boreholes if we understand it as viable investment, health needs, security needs, etc. Using traditional mechanic mechanical machines. The cost of digging 11,000 boreholes in the Gambia can be around $20 million at the moment. Later, I will explain a system of digging at a fraction of the cost and time. For now, let us ask why the governments and carried folks around the world refuse this investment. You and I must raise their awareness. Although sometimes the people are the problem, government seems to be part of the problem in the world of agriculture in Africa. Every summer, Lamindaranka and many places in the Gambia have gardens, beautiful gardens due to free rain. But garden lot less in other seasons due to water costs, obviously. Some youths even go to the provinces, but semi-drought of no rain for 2 to 3 weeks means ruin season. It means a ruin season and discouraging them from farming. About time for governments to dig enough boreholes, or the people to farm, then reasonably tax without fear or starving the people. One bad season reduces government foreign currency earnings in the millions. Is it not smarter for governments to dig enough boreholes? Resist drought, have year-round farming, increase its foreign currency earnings through agriculture, tourism, and beyond. By having free water, we can easily demand over 100 types of herbs and vegetables be produced in the Gambia for balanced diet and to attract tourists. We can have food forests to attract better tourists than zoos. We can feed our animals much better, plant more trees, and reduce pollution. Your house address or month of birth can determine which produce you must produce for your country to maintain variety and availability in the world of produce. The so-called disadvantages of free water policy are subsided. The number and kind of jobs water companies provide are too minimal compared to the jobs free water will directly and indirectly provide in Africa. In regards to water wasting, cameras and meters can be used in some cases. It is much harder to waste water in Africa because there is hardly water recollection system. And no sane person will float a compound. You wouldn't allow others to flood your compound as well. Watering the unpaved streets means less dust, and the sun will react on it to return as rain. Swimming pools will improve our health, and that water can be reused to garden. More swimming pools and plumbing materials can easily earn the government a lot more than the about $10 per compound water bill at the moment. It's common sense, government. Let's do it. Again, the mild droughts in most of Black Africa can be easily resisted if the Lord continue to bless us as of the present and the past. Such resistance is appreciation of new blessings by the Lord of the universe, the Lord of the water that comes above and under the earth. He allowed us to have wells, now helping us with boreholes. They consume a lot less space than wells and work better. So we want enough boreholes, not more than the wells we had. Offering free water must come with sensitizations for the best outcome. Encourage the people to plant trees to pay for the cost. Plant trees to pay for your children's school fees and AU water tax as example. About $100 AU water tax per decade for every adult or long-term visitor with less than $10,000 verifiable taxpayer receipts in Africa. One bag of cashew nuts, as example, or X tons of hemp to be paid within 3 years after the free water policy is launched. are all compromisable ways we can work on. Otherwise, you may have lazy folks guaranteed free food, and that may anger the Lord, risking punishment. Now do the maths. How many millions can your country collect through free water policy? If you are unemployed by people, plant trees, bamboo for housing, garden for food, etc. Nature has almost unlimited employment for us in Africa. Boreholes just make the employment easier and more assuring. Every African teenager, including girls, should be advised at school to plant three cashew trees, soursop, sweet sop, baobab, avocado, breadfruit, or something similar to consume and help pay for school fees. Not just depend on parents asking orders or government subsidies. Government should subsidize water before your schooling. If they can afford to subsidize your schooling, I will definitely encourage them. But for now, let's encourage everyone to get up and do something. Let us have the free water policy and ask the people to work harder. Eating and eating enough are two different things many Africans should learn about. We produce cashew nuts and consume them, while others consume enough of it year-round. Sharing one carrot or eggplant with a whole compound cannot be wise or eating enough. Now cost is partly to blame. But with free water policy, efforts and state of minds must be raised or we will remain the same and not get the full benefits. Will the AU ministers please sign on time or very late? Introducing new vegetables, herbs, and nuts is crucial and should not be compromised. The Quran hints us heaven is where you have variety of food, variety of quality food, while hell has limited food. Like the rest of the world, Africa is seeing a surge of child obesity, and we must smartly confront it. Rather than banning or keep introducing them to candies and fried food, every country must promote at least 7 nutritious nuts for consumption, not just money. Almond, chestnuts, pistachios, etc. should not be for only rich folks and should be available year-round for us. Rather than banning soda, introducing countless soda drinks, or fighting with the kids, we must introduce vegetable juice in variety. We have to give the people better options, and it requires much more than what Africa produces at the moment. Also, do not wait on the government. Buy the seeds, search on the internet on how to plant them, visit farms, and pressure your family members in Africa to farm and garden more. Free water policy should mean much higher health for Africa, especially our children. This movement for free water policy will improve our democracy and reduce corruption. As the population eats better, they will feel less, worry less, and think better. Our children can be introduced to more vegetables through a vegetarian school feeding program. We must try to encourage vegetarianism in Africa for different reasons. Parents can pay with money or produce. Besides humans, animal lives will improve as grateful guardians of the earth. Imagine contributing to the improvement of billions or millions of lives. Help spread the message and see yourself as such. Vote for only the political parties that publicly endorse this movement and approach. Do not for a minute underestimate the possible good through this initiative. Free water translates to almost free food in Africa, which means less worries and more productive people. It means new inventions are around the corner and some research gets cheaper in Africa. It means a prosperous Africa is ever more realistic and probable, not just possible. May the Lord bless Africa and the sincere friends of Africa. A new technique to drill boreholes. Saving time and money is smart beyond boreholes. The bulky material the Western world sells to Africa and other poor countries to dig boreholes are outdated, unfit as gifts, and deceptive as sales after this wisdom I am about to unveil. Technology and common sense demand evolution in every aspect of life. A submersible electric blender with replaceable concrete nail types of blade can easily rotate to drill better than the outdated, heavy and bulky material. Alongside the blender, we will need submersible mud pump and submersible camera to choose the preferred soil type for the submersible water pump. Submersible camera is much smarter, cheaper, and more efficient than the electric logging many borehole drilling companies use. This combination of equipment can easily be made to retail under $500, or at least under $1,000 for sure, and can be designed as single or multiple units. It can be operated with a car or pickup truck and a trailer for the PVC pipes. Almost every village has a smartphone, so every village will ultimately be able to have the full drilling set. You'll be able to drill a borehole under 1 hour with the right equipment or right team. Meaning one team can drill over 1,000 boreholes in a year. Of course, we ultimately pray for most compounds to have a borehole as most compounds have wells. Let smart business people and governments team up for this marijuana-inspired invention. The water pipe drills and soften for the blender. The rotation of concrete nail blades will dig. The mud pump sucks. The camera help dictate the speed and type of drill options, etc. You call engineers with blender experience, submersible pump or any electronics waterproof experience, fan, washing machine or any rotating machine experience, drone experience, etc. Nigeria, Senegal, South Africa, Ghana, Ethiopia, Kenya, even the Gambia may have enough engineers to work on such a project. Asia, Russia, Arabia, and the Western world, you're also invited to take up this challenge as caring friends of Africa or ProArt. Asia reportedly dug boreholes with bamboo sticks. Some Africans are using cheap metals to manually dig boreholes. This much smarter approach will certainly work. Invest to help people while making millions or billions. And please remember to be grateful to the Lord, Africa, and the volunteers who helped you with the information. The PVC piping is a bulk of the cost in boreholes, around $200 per borehole as of now with oil prices going down. If we legalize hemp or marijuana, the hemp plastic piping will cost a lot less. Again, we do not have to follow their commercial-oriented standards, but use common sense and respect every needed standard. The submersible pumps are reasonably priced, around $100, that is the water pumps, and can go down as demand rises towards every compound and farm with a borehole. I prefer electric water pump over solar pumps at the moment, then use solar or wind to power it up. I also prefer wind turbine over solar due to ease of maintenance, plus air is available 24 hours, especially with more trees. Using an inverter through your vehicle's DC outlet, you can dig a borehole. You can also use generators. Electric borehole drilling is realistic and much more efficient. Let the governments offer water supply, but have your own borehole for security reasons. If there is war and they choose to cut water supply, you won't be affected. If they put fluoride or something you do not trust in the water, you have option. Trust yourself than the government on food, water, and sex. Their regulations and suggestions are not always great. Please do not masturbate or buy their sex toys. Garden where possible to avoid GMO. Although I do not know of any scientific sign that frowns at concentrated water drawing, water collection, I prefer distributed water drawing as knowledge improves. We will compromise with governments who want to charge water in the summer because we should build our houses to collect rainwater in the summer. African builders must include boreholes, Badafoss green fields, and or greenhouses in their proposals. African governments can demand about 25% of all compounds be reserved for trees or gardening as a standard. Landowners to farm or allow citizens to garden on unused land. Pay reasonable commission through produce or money. People should not be allowed to abuse orders through land ownership. We need land tax or free it up for potential taxpayers to farm on it. I believe in land leasing, that is lifelong leasing instead of land owning, and no land inheriting. But that is a different topic and need some unlearning for some of you to accept. Why Gambia as example? It is the smallest country on mainland Africa, almost no minerals, considered poor in many ways. I also happen to be from the country, knows it very well. If we can transform this country through free water policy and other simple initiatives to improve African lives, other countries will have hope and no excuse to follow suit. Of course, let no country wait for the Gambia. The Lord and myself are here for Africa and beyond. Call it Black Africa Spring or whatever, but remain peaceful and discuss it enough before any risky protests. I am not a big fan of protests. However, if they refuse to respond by 2017, then we can consider monthly mass protests for free water policy. Now I call on you to help spread the message of the movement. Write to your media houses, politicians, business people, etc. Print flyers or form a political party for it if need be. As a pressure group, urge them to help feed the poor. The marvelous Quran and common sense said, people will be in hell for not urging for the feeding of the poor. So it's very important that we urge them to feed them, to feed the poor, including free water. He gave the water free of charge. Governments are just abusing us, asking too much money. Better than feeding the poor or ordering for their feeding is helping them feed themselves. We thank you, Lord of the universe, for the awesome inspirations, courage, and beautiful glad tidings. May all those who spread the message with love be in paradise. May the Lord proportionately cause those who ignore or fight the message to delay the realization of free water in Africa. May the Lord bless soul of Trinity. Let's learn, let's work, let's have fun. Thank you all. May God bless you.